Cubase has some very powerful stock plugins to do pitch correction, which I'll show you. If after this you still want to try the auto-tune, go get your free trial, link in the description. So the first thing you got to do is make a stylistic choice. Do you want to hear the pitch correction very obviously, or do you want to be more subtle about it? I'll show you how to do both. Here I have a vocal recording and I'm going to go to inserts and add pitch correct. This plugin kind of looks and works like auto-tune. You can use a preset, but I recommend you adjust these settings. The speed determines how fast the pitch is going to get corrected, and the tolerance is the sensitivity of the correction. For example, if you have a vocal with a lot of vibrato and you don't want those notes to be included in the pitch correction, you can raise the tolerance. If you turn the speed all the way up and the tolerance all the way down, then you get that extreme auto-tune effect.
I've been looking out.
You can also transpose the entire vocal in case you need that.
I've been looking out.
Here you have the scale settings. If you choose internal, you get these options. Chromatic is going to pitch the audio to the closest semitone. If you know what key the vocal is in, then you can choose major or minor and pick the right one. And on these keys, you'll see which notes are included. But you can also completely customize it and tell the plugin which notes you're going to be using. And if you want to reset it, click this orange line. If you go for external source, you can control the plugin with an external controller or a MIDI track and have it follow the scale or the individual notes. To do that, create a MIDI track and set the output to the Pitch Correct plugin.
I've been looking out for somebody just like you.
And if you have a chord track, you can also use that for chords or scales. So create a chord track, and with the pencil tool, I'm just going to create random chords. And if I hit play,
I've been looking out.
You can see how it changes.
For somebody just like you. But then you walk on by.
Lastly, you have some formant options. Shift is what you'll find in auto-tune as the throat dial, the style of the voice.
I've been looking out for somebody just like you.
You can optimize this for lower and higher pitched vocals. If you want to keep the original character of the voice, you keep preservation on. If you turn it off, you get some weird effects.
I've been looking out for somebody just like you.
So that's pitch correct. If you want to go into more detail, you'll want to use VariAudio, which you can use separately or in combination with pitch correct. So double click on the vocal, and here in the inspector under VariAudio, click this button, and then it analyzes your audio. You can zoom in if you want to. This is a very visual tool. Within these segments, you see exactly what the pitch is doing, and the average pitch of a segment determines what note is placed on, and every note has its own color. But if you want good results, you don't want to get distracted by all this wobbly pitch information, and then just select all and go in here, and correct pitch, 100%, straighten curve, 100%, because then you'll get a robot.
Eyes bloodshot and I'm faded now. I try calling to persuade you how.
In VariAudio, you kind of want to go in note by note. To make that process easier, go in here and choose Show All Smart Controls. Those are these handles that all have their own functionality. If you hover over them, you get the info. This square is for tilting, and so is this one. And the breakpoint for tilting is set by this one. This one in the middle is going to straighten the curve. And you can also see these change over here, by the way. And the one on the bottom here is to pitch correct the entire segment. This one on the left is to shift the formant. And the one on the right to set the volume. And you see this white solid line here? If you hover over that, you'll get the split tool. If you have a lot of pitch variation within a segment and you want to work on that segment, I feel like it's best to go in and make a cut right where the pitch kind of leaves the segment. and then the new segment is going to get assigned to the correct note. So right now this didn't change the pitch, but it makes it easier to work on these segments. If you hover over these dotted lines, you don't get the cut tool, but the glue tool. On the left, it glues it to the previous one. On the right, or if you shift click on the solid line, it's getting glued to the next one. And then one last handle that's controlling the pitch. It's actually two, one here and one here. Those set a range that is left alone when you're straightening the pitch curve. And that allows you to straighten it while still keeping a natural transition between the notes. So if I don't set a range,
by my side,
very unnatural. And if I do set it,
by my side,
much better, depending on what you're looking for. And then you see two more handles on the sides. You can use those to correct the timing.
I try calling to persuade you how. I try calling to persuade you how.
Or if you hold Option or Alt and drag, you can make this part invisible for VariAudio, so whatever you do in VariAudio doesn't affect it. This can be very useful for any sibilants, because if you pitch correct things like S's or harsh T's, you're gonna get artifacts that really mess up your recording. So if you're getting weird sounding, sharp, robotic sibilants, then make sure you hide those. A lot of times these atonal parts are already separate segments, so in that case you can just click and delete it. This is not deleting any audio, it's just hiding it from VariAudio. The toolbar over here is comparable to the main toolbar. To me, the most important button on here is this one, acoustic feedback, which allows you to hear the segments when you click them. By the way, if you don't want to snap to the notes, you can hold shift, and then you can drag the segments wherever you want. So let's go back to the inspector and look at some more controls. The snap mode, absolute will snap to the notes. Relative will snap to the note as well, but keep the relative position of the segment. So this one is slightly under the note, and when I move it relatively, it will stay that way. And off is the same as holding shift. Here you can choose to control the pitch with MIDI, and the scale assistant helps you choose the right notes. You can use this to create harmonies as well, that is, if you make unique copies of the audio. I personally don't use this, but I did make a separate video about it a while back, so I'll add it below. And then one more useful function is over here. Reset all changes for selection. You can select all segments, Command or Control A, or just click and drag to select a few. Or just like in the piano roll, you can Command or Control click on the piano to select every segment on that note. And then reset everything you selected if you want to start over. So I hope that helped. If it did, please like the video
and also subscribe
and have fun making music.